Heat distortion is a really cool effect, and today I'm going to be showing you guys two different ways that you can do it inside of DaVinci Resolve to any object, whether that be text, a video, or anything else that you might want to add it to. The best part about this is both the methods can be used in both the paid and free version of DaVinci Resolve 17. Jumping into DaVinci Resolve, I'm going to be showing you guys the first method, which is the fastest and the best looking. Inside of Fusion, I have this awesome clip of a burning building that I got off ArtGrid, and we have this text over above it that's just roughly tracked into the scene, and I want to add heat distortion to it to make it feel like it is actually a part of the scene. To make the text, I just took a text node and then had that go into a soft glow node to add that nice little bright glow around it, and then used a color corrector node to add an orange hue to that glow. I then just took a few trackers in a tracker node and tracked my scene, and then applied that to the text using a transform node. But for the heat distortion, we're going to be taking advantage of a new plugin called Mirage. Mirage has been developed by David from Learn Now Effects, and it makes realistic heat distortion really easy to do. If you guys want to get this plugin for yourself, you can do that at the link in the description, and using the code down there, you can get 10% off when you purchase it. Once you guys buy it and download it, all you need to do is drag the installer file into Fusion's node graph, follow the steps inside of the menu, and then restart Fusion, and it will be ready to use. Okay, to add the node in, we're gonna do shift space on our keyboard, and then we're going to type Mirage. And I am going to add it right after the color corrector node here, so that it is before the transform that moves it around. Now the Mirage node has a ton of controls, and it might be a little overwhelming at first, so let's just walk through each of them one by one. So up at the top we have the render settings. We can change what the node is outputting via this drop down menu. So right now we see the final result, but we can also view the distortion map, we can view the map height, and we can also view the heat map. Once it's time to render, you're going to want to be using the final result so that you can see the heat distortion applied to your image, or in this case text. Next up, we have settings like distortion strength, height, the heat amount, and the evolution rate. Usually these are going to be the first controls that you are going to tweak with your heat effect. For me, I want really high distortion strength, distortion height, I want the heat amount to be way up as well, and then I want an evolution rate of about 0.6. So if we watch that, we can already see there's just a little bit of distortion to the text here. So let's say I view the two different versions off to the side here. So on the left is without any heat distortion, and on the right we have heat distortion. So as you can see, it applies a really cool looking effect to it. But next up we have the distortion noise settings, and that's what's going to be driving the displacement of the heat distortion. So first up, I'm going to change the noise type from smoke to fire. That'll just give you a better fire look. And then I'm going to bring the scale up to 1.2. And then add just a little bit of distortion contrast, let's say about 0.2. So as you can see, the heat distortion is looking really intense on this text already. And if we view it in the final scene, it is looking really good. And then we have the heat noise settings. I'm going to bring the scale up to 3.6 and the heat detail all the way up to 4. And then I'll bring the heat contrast down to about 0.2. Finally, we can adjust the wind settings. I'm going to keep it so it's moving in an upward direction, and then I'm going to bring the wind speed to about 1.8. And there we go, we have our heat distortion. And that is how you make heat distortion using the awesome Mirage plugin. Again, if you guys want that, there is a link down below where you can pick it up. And now onto the completely free way to make this effect. But before we do that, if you guys are enjoying this video or finding it useful, please consider giving it a like and saying hi down in the comments below. And now let's get into the free method. Okay, so first up, I'm gonna delete my Mirage node, and now I'm going to give myself a little bit more room here because we can't just do this with one node anymore. We're gonna start off by adding in a displace node, so shift space to add that in. And in order for the displace node to work, we need a displacement map. A displacement map is an image that tells our displace node what to displace based on luma values. So pretty much where there is solid white on the screen, there's gonna be the maximum amount of displacement. And where it's black, there's going to be no displacement at all. We are going to create our displacement effect using a fast noise node. So I'm going to grab down a fast noise node and view it off to the side over here. So as you can see, it's randomly generating luma values from 0 to 1. And we can adjust those settings up in the top here with the detail contrast and all that. So the first step is going to be to connect this into the displacement node. And in the display setting, I'm going to bring this down to -0.038. So there's just going to be a very little bit of distortion, but just a little bit is what's gonna look the best. You do not want the distortion to be over the top, otherwise it won't look like heat distortion. Now we wanna adjust the settings in the fast noise node to get a better looking displacement. So I'm going to set my detail to 4.56, I'm gonna set my contrast to 1.95, and then I'm going to set my brightness to -1, and I will scale it up to 12.28 and add a seethe rate of 0.661. And now if we just view this fast noise and play it, as you can see, we just have these random noise patterns generating and moving over time because of the seethe rate. So let's view the media out, and we can see it is now being applied onto our text. But heat moves up, so we want to convey that with our heat distortion. So what we need to do is come to fast noise and add a keyframe on the center X and Y at frame 0. Then I'll come 50 frames forward and put this at, let's say, 0.8. And now as you can see, our fast noise is moving up. We can come to the spline editor and select the fast noise node and select the two keyframes and then do set relative. And that'll make this continue upwards at the same speed forever. And if we want to adjust the speed of it, all we have to do is come grab this top keyframe and hold shift and drag it left to right. So left it'll go faster, right it'll go slower. So let's speed it up just a very little bit, and I think that's looking pretty good. Okay, so now let's add in a very blurred node. Okay, and we'll just copy this fast noise and paste it off to the side here and connect it up into the very blur node. Now what I'll do is just adjust the seethe, bring it up to like 6 or something, and that'll make it different than the first node. And then I will also add a little bit more contrast in. Let's view this node. Add some contrast in, and then bring the detail down to about there. And now inside of the very blur node, let's bring set the blur channel to be Luma. And then I can bring the blur size up, and now as you can see, it is blurring the image wherever the displacement map is telling it to. And again, that's based on the Luma values. So if I just bring the blur size and the quality up, we now have this blurred effect going on in certain spots of the text effect. And since we copied the fast noise node, it'll be moving at the same speed as the first one. And that is the second way that you guys can create heat distortion. If you guys have any other methods that you might want to use, let me know down in the comments below. If you found this video useful, please give it a like. And with that being said, I'll see you guys next time for another video.